Paul and Silas, remember, when Paul cast out that demon out that little girl, because she was saying, these are the men of God, show us the way to salvation, and it started to irritate Paul. Paul turned around and said, Satan, the Lord rebuke you, come up off that girl. It was a soothsaying spirit. Got cast out. When the owners found out that their gain was gone, because she was bringing her owners much gain through soothsaying. And Paul cast that spirit out that little girl. And now when she went to divine, or they was expecting something from her, she couldn't produce. And got mad. And they found Paul and them. That's how Paul and them ended up in prison. Because he was doing the work of God. Paul and Silas was together. They was praising and praying. About midnight, they started to pray. Right before transition, right before, come on somebody. See that 11:59 is important. Some of y'all is like 60 minutes, 60 seconds from breakthrough. Y'all at 11:59, just getting ready to step over. Just getting ready to step over that 11:50, that 12th hour about to hit your life.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory. That 12th hour about to hit your life. Just one more tick to 12. If you can hold out for 60 more seconds, there's going to be an earthquake over shackles. Hallelujah. There's already been a shift because you started praising him. But there's 60 seconds left for you to hold out. Just one more minute. God's going to rush down and bust up your situation and free everything around you. Oh my God. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to his holy name. Man, if you can just hold out for 60 more seconds. Just 60 more seconds. Just one more minute. Amen. Of praising and lifting him up. God has already shifted the atmosphere. He's already set up something miraculous. He's already set up a great deliverance, because before it hits earth, it already was released from heaven. They already seen you in bondage because you're doing something good. The enemy tried to make it bad, but God said, I'm going to switch that whole thing around for you.
Lord, thank you, God.
Because see, in that jail, there was more people that needed to be saved.
Yes, Lord.
There was more people that needed to see a miracle. So God dropped Paul and Silas behind enemy lines, bam, and locked them down. But it was the character of Paul and Silas that allowed breakthrough to come at midnight. Y'all gotta catch that. It was the character, what they were saying, what they were singing, how they carried themselves, locked in the stocks, feet fast in the stocks, in mud, in a dungeon. Y'all gotta catch. Oh, hallelujah. Dropped in a jail when there was all kind of stuff happening down there. It wasn't sophisticated with TVs and all kind of stuff that we have in jail right now. Amen. And nice clothes, even though they all the same color. Amen. Praise God. I've been there. I know. Amen. Hallelujah. I experienced that. I'm not the same, though. That's why God, when it's time for prison time, then he sent me back to the prison. Because I understand both sides. I understand being free and being bound spiritually and naturally. Understand the attitude and what they go through, and how fearful you can be, and how arrogant it can make you, like you did something great and big, and you spent almost 40 years of your life in prison. You come out like, yeah, I'm just, it changes your mentality. And then to try to do it again and do it better, and you already got caught 4 times, and you want to try it again to make sure you don't get away the 5th. Come on, something is wrong with that way of thinking. But that's what that atmosphere makes you do. That's why how Satan will make you think. To give you a better way to do it better, so you don't get caught, so you get good at it. And to mess you up, and you keep going down and under, and it totally destroys you, or you get life. Amen, praise God. Because you got a powerful gift, and God don't want, and Satan don't want it to be seen. And so Daniel, man, I gotta quit with this. And so Daniel, as Paul and Silas get dropped behind enemy lines, check out the total scheme of things. They begin to praise and prayer. This is character now. Earthquake hits, everybody gets free. Amen. Earthquake hits. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Earthquake hits. Amen. Everybody gets free. Check this. Earthquake hits, everybody gets free. But the jailer's getting ready to kill itself. Character now. The character of Paul. The character of Paul comes out. Paul could have said, you put me in jail, go ahead and kill yourself. I don't care about you or nobody else. I'm free. I'm out. God freed me. That could have been his attitude. That could have been his character. That I got mine and I'm gone. Come on, somebody. That's why you got to be careful. When God blesses you, you got to ask the question, what do you want me to do with this? Who do you want me to help with this? Get that brand new car. Who do you want me to help? Who needs a ride to church? Who needs a ride to the grocery store? Make yourself available to help somebody else out with the new vehicle or the new transportation or whatever God gave you, more than what you had before. Ask God, what do you want me to do with this? Who do you want me to help with this great abundance that I just got? What money you want me to sow into? Where you want me to give something to? How many shirts you want me to give away? Whatever it is, whatever abundance God got for you, before you go and use it on yourself and mess it all up. Come on, somebody. Ask God, what would you have me to do with what you just gave me?
Yes,
now,